I'm Julia, I'm a specialist practitioner community school nurse and previously worked as a health visitor for 20 years. I'm a mother of three and my youngest daughter is now 14 years old. Elizabeth, when she was first born, about 7 days old, started having these fits, these twitching episodes. Instinctively, I somehow felt that they were nothing really serious, but they were very worrying. At 2 months, she was scheduled to start her immunisations. And although I'd been reassured that she wasn't epileptic, I still had in the back of my mind, what if she was? And a whooping cough, one of the contraindications was always, if you were epileptic, not to have it.
One question I'm often asked as a paediatrician with a special interest in vaccines relates to immunising children with a history of epilepsy or seizures against whooping cough. Prior to 2004 in the United Kingdom, we were using an old version of the whooping cough vaccine known as wholesale pertussis. And that vaccine simply took the pertussis bacteria that causes whooping cough, inactivated it, and put it into a vaccine. And that vaccine had more than 3,000 different proteins that the immune system was responding to. And perhaps not surprisingly, it did have quite high rates of local reactions and high rates of fever, and reactions such as febrile convulsions when children developed a seizure with a fever after immunisation. So since 2004, we're using a more refined version of that vaccine, which contains only 5 proteins, which are just the proteins that the immune system needs to recognise in order to protect against whooping cough. So that vaccine was introduced in 2004 in the United Kingdom. It's given as part of the 5-in-1 vaccine at 2, 3 and 4 months of age. And that vaccine causes far fewer local reactions and lower rates of fever. And in countries where it's been used in wide-scale use, there is a clear evidence that there are lower rates of febrile convulsions with that vaccine as well. So I think, therefore, the advice is quite clear. Even if a child's had a history of seizures or epilepsy, as long as that is a stable condition, then these children should be receiving the new whooping cough vaccine.
As a parent, you have these fears and it's your baby and your precious bundle and you're making these very important decisions. You know, we'd had this worrying period of time and I just didn't feel I was getting enough reassurance that it was okay and it was safe. So decided to proceed, but without having the whooping cough element.
Now, understandably, there can be some anxiety from families where they've had a child who has seizures or epilepsy diagnosed about whether to go ahead with the immunisations or not. But I guess with all these things, you need to look at the other side of the story, is that there is a very real risk of whooping cough infection if the immunisations are delayed. And so if the paediatricians or the GP caring for that child think it is appropriate, then it's important to go ahead and get the vaccines. And this is especially important given the increase in disease that we're seeing at the moment, where high numbers of children getting whooping cough. And it's important to remember that this is especially affecting children in the first 6 months of life, where they're particularly vulnerable to this disease, and this is where the deaths, unfortunately, are occurring.
She's now 14 years old, and there's been a big increase in the number of cases of whooping cough, and it really made me realise how vulnerable she was, because she had no protection at all. So I decided to have her inoculated at our GP surgery with 2 doses of the Repavax, which is the diphtheria, tetanus and whooping cough. So she had those over the summer at a month apart, and fortunately with no side effects. So I just feel pleased that she's now got some protection. I think what I would say to any parents now is that if you've got any particular concerns about your baby or child, it speak to a specialist, speak to a paediatrician, someone that really knows about your baby, about your child, about their condition or the history, and discuss your fears and anxieties with them.